No, about the end of history was an illusion, and not only European illusion, but an American illusion, illusions everywhere. End of history, come on. It meant in Hegel something. In Hegel meant end of history, that modernity is the end of history. And Hegel had damn right. But he did not mean that democracy is the end of history, because it would be wrong. And it's wrong. Hannah Arendt, referred to Hannah Arendt, said totalitarianism as modern as liberal democracy. It's awesome. It grows out from modernity. We should not believe that modernity is about liberal democracy. Then we lose our head and lose our European values, if I may say so. So, what happened? That happened that people started to believe in this progress. It is better and better. We are going to live better and better each and every year. This does not lead anywhere, because if you do not know the history behind you, will not create a history ahead of you. I think we are now at a kind of a point where it can be both ways, like the prophet said in the Bible. And if you do this, this is going to happen. If you do that, that is going to happen. And it might be the case that Orban's position and the position of Visegrad 4, particularly Poland and Hungary, will have a great support by other European nations. Also in Germany, maybe the alternative for Deutschland will be stronger. Or in France, I don't think that many places in the world, in Holland, there is a very strong right-wing party. In Denmark, there is a very strong right-wing party. In Italy, you know what's going on, and you know what's going on in Austria. So basically, it can happen that at one point, the majority of European Union will be nationalistic, egoistic, private interest, national interest, the ethnic nationalism, political nationalism. And in this case, Europe is going to be lose itself. And as I said many times, that's the last chance of Europe.